He's part of one of the best shows on television from Better Call Saul. Welcome, Michael Mando. How are you?
Thank you. Very well. Thank you for having me. Good morning.
Really good to see you. So, some big news came out of Comic-Con last month, and that Better Call Saul is now going to finally cross over with Breaking Bad. Are you excited about that? Are the fans excited about that?
Absolutely. You know, we have Gus Fring, you know, one of the greatest villains in television history, who's back. And he's one of Nacho's main obstacles in order to saving his father. We have Hector Salamanca, who is the gentleman in the wheelchair with the bell.
Yeah.
Who now we find out Nacho is actually responsible for putting him in that wheelchair. So we're going back and we're explaining sort of how these epic characters got to where they are.
Right.
And you said, we were talking right before we went on air, that this is going to be the best season of the show so far.
I believe so. You know, I think in any great show, what you want is you want the new show to be, the newest season to be better than the last, and so on and so forth. And, you know, Vince Gilligan and Peter Gould are among the best, you know, that ever have been in the business. And that's really how they write their seasons. I really believe this is our best by far. We hit the pavement running, and if anybody saw the last episode that aired, you know, I think we have a clip from it, and
yeah.
It just ends with, it's pretty intense, and it actually gets even worse in the next two.
Oh, awesome.
Well, you brought it up. Let's take a look at that clip.
I know what you've done. The Salamancas, they do not. Do you understand what I'm saying? Get me. From now on, you are mine.
Ooh,
whoa. Wow.
Okay, that's a good way to end.
It's not a comedy.
No.
But it is. But it is, too. You know, it's one of those great shows where, I mean, this is not really the best morning scene.
Right.
But it's got these incredible dark moments. And then it's got these really, really funny moments, you know, that it's really a great show. It's got both elements going at the same time.
I was wondering, this may be a strange question, but I read that you moved 10 cities, 4 different continents, and 37 different homes before your mid-20s.
Oh, I don't
Is
know
that
about
true?
I don't know about the exact numbers.
Really?
But we moved around a lot. Yeah, I was born in Quebec City, and then I grew up most of my life in Africa, actually, in Ivory Coast and Ghana.
Ah.
And we moved around quite a bit. I lived in Paris and France, and then moved around across Canada, and then a couple of years ago moved to California.
Do you think that helps you when taking on these roles, just because you've seen so much and you've had to adapt to all these different situations?
Absolutely. I think, and I recommend it for everybody, if you can travel, do it. If you can travel and live in different places, it's even better, because you get to experience, you know, different experiences of life, like a paradigm shift. Every culture is so specific and can inform you on how to live life maybe a little bit with more richness.
Can you speak French?
Yes, I'm francophone.
Can you speak it for us
now? À tous ceux qui regardent Better Call Saul, ça me fait grand plaisir et j'espère que vous avez aimé la nouvelle épisode.
Yeah.
That's hot.
Works for you.
Oh my God, it's so good.
Yeah.
I'm so glad. You know, it's so interesting to see you. You've picked for yourself so well, like Orphan Black. You've picked your shows so well. So it's so good to see you. I think you've done such a phenomenal job. We're all excited for you to be here.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
I really appreciate
good
it.
Good to see you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Better Call Saul airs Mondays at 9 p.m. on AMC. That's for you, Mark. Mondays at 9.
All AMC. Right. There you go.
You're welcome.